others were just having little ones, you know.
Paul's back at last from his appointment with the consultant. Will he or won't he have to be admitted to hospital?
Right. Hello, Paul.
All right.
How'd you get on then?
What did he actually say when he went in there?
Yeah, he just asked me how I was feeling, and I said, I actually, you know, feel better, but I've got a little bit of discomfort down in the side there, and he just said, yeah, and just muttered on about something, and they said, well, we're going to bring you in and we'll admit you as soon as possible. When can you come in? They're going to try it for a few more days on a maximum dose of steroids, and if that don't work, they're going to take the colon out. As he says, what? Rip it out and throw it in the bin. That's how we put it.
No, I don't think he's putting a brave face on it, but an operation is what he's been dreading.
So they're going to cut the whole colon out?
So they're going to take it all away. And that's the only prize to be gained, he said. Just take it away and the disease will be gone. You won't ever have any more trouble. He said, but it might not come from that. He said, but just in case it does, we get the surgeons to come round and see you. We just have to... We just have to grin and bear it, I suppose. I've got to explain it to Tony and Chris. Just hope that they're a bit understanding now as what they were earlier on in the year. There we have it.
It's a bit disappointing.
Very, yeah, I was expecting good news, but I never got it, so.
In fact, for Tony, the news he's to lose one of his key farmhands has come at a bad time.
How far behind are you, Tony, at the moment?
Oh. Fortnight, 3 weeks? Must be. But against that, nature takes its time. And nature will always happen at the right time, whatever you're doing. But, I mean, we are behind.
What was your reaction when you heard the news about Paul?
I wouldn't dare tell you in English. But it was bloody bad luck, actually. The whole thing's been a bit bad luck with him. I mean, they haven't sorted him out yet. And he's one of a gang. And one makes a difference at the right time of the year. This time of the year, when you're really pushing yourself, one makes a lot of difference, because you can only do a certain amount.
You're about to become very busy, aren't you?
We're about to come busy, and this is when you want everybody.
If he's off for a few months, that could cause problems, couldn't it?
Cause problems right the way through. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I wished on the moon for something I never knew.
PC Pinky Salmon, the night he's been meticulously planning for 3.5 weeks, has finally arrived.
Hi. Hi. Did Dad mention that I was here tonight?
Briefly, yeah.
Okay.
Chair.
Yeah, please, if
drink
you've got one.
Like that?
No, I'll be okay with the regards to drinks. Well, hopefully we'll get somebody tonight.
Right. Thanks so much.
It could be one of the longest nights of his career. For the next 8 hours, he must remain completely alert, completely silent, a coiled spring waiting to leap into action. Meanwhile, just down the road at the Star, a celebration. The couple taking over the pub from Alison are holding a getting-to-know-you evening. And with free drinks all round, there's no shortage of takers.
Yeah, what a good idea.
You should know about it for now.
You should.
Tony wastes no time chatting up the new landlady.
Essex, where?
Oh, in Essex, yes.
You're a lady of Essex or an Essex lady?
No, I'm not. I'm a lady of Lincolnshire.
Oh, Lincolnshire, another poacher.
She's a yellow belly. Excuse me, Tony.
But it's Alison, who used to run the place, who's about to steal the limelight. Pinky's intuition is that tonight must be the night. With nothing more than Carp Weekly to keep him company, this will be a long, lonely, and potentially dangerous vigil.
Are you really going to spend all night here?
Yes.
Until when?
Probably about 6 o'clock in the morning, when Alan arrives.
Why tonight, particularly?
The last two break-ins, there was about a 3.5 week gap in between, and it's been, we've worked, sat down and worked it out, and it looks like that tonight could be the night.
It's a hell of a way to spend a night, isn't it? I mean, I thought you have a sleeping bag and an alarm clock or something. Why not?
I think if I had a sleeping bag, I'd probably fall asleep. it'd be very, very difficult to explain the following day when there's no cigarettes and no wine and no booze there, and there's me lying, on the floor.
You had a good night's sleep.
Yeah, I had a good night's sleep, because I must admit, I do like my sleep, and at times I can be quite a heavy sleeper.
Whatever Alison's news is, it's certainly bringing a smile to everyone's lips.
You look after it.
Well done about that.
Good girls are scared.
See?
Then you behave.
Yeah.
Good luck.
She's scared.
Well done. Well done.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
Well, it's
right.
I've got lipstick on me now. How long have you been there?
3 years, just. We was engaged to be married, and when I took this place over, he disappeared. But he's back, and yesterday he asked me to marry him.
Did he go on bended knee?
No, did he, hell.
What did he do?
I just basically said, will you take me back? Which he said yes. I said, well, this will shock you even more then. Will you marry me? She said yes.
What is it about Alison that, you know, you want to marry?
Not my money.
No, it's definitely not my money. As for the personality, I don't know about that either. I've still got the bruises and marks to prove it. I don't know. It's, just can't get her out of my head.
Oh, it's a sweetie, isn't he? It's a baby.
So what are you going to tell everybody?
We see Pinky yesterday in town, and by the time we got back here, most of the pub knew. And apparently there's some phone calls going around at 1:45 this morning that me and him are back together and getting married.
In the early hours of this morning, they were ringing each other up.
Bentley's buzzing at the moment.
Next morning, on the bypass site, a critical stage in the newly engaged Alison's business venture.
How many have you got, Alison?
10.
Well, that's quite good for a start, isn't it?
It is. Hopefully it should pick up, though.
What's the most popular one?
Corned beef, I think. That's going to be really popular with the workmen.
What do they like to deal with? Are they all right?
They're smashing.
They don't take the mickey?
No, not yet, anyway.
Not yet.
I'm hungry for something, but it seems so far away. That sentimental sandwich.
9 out of 10 for delivery and presentation.
That'd have been a lovely, it's nice and thick.
Well, I hope so. I shouldn't think there'd be any complaints, but you have to let me know.
Not till lunchtime, though, will Alison's corned beef and pickle face its ultimate test.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
Okay.
See you then.
Coming up.
It's morning after the night's boozy celebrations at the Star, and for his routine inspection of the hop fields, it's a painfully early start for Tony Holmes.
But if you put them across, you can see them, and they don't fly up around the pole.
So the hops are just beginning to appear now?
Just coming through.
But Tony's got other things on his mind. Rumour has it that a family feud is about to erupt.
Tony, what's all this about you and Jumbo, your brother-in-law, having a bit of a barney? Is this what I've heard? Is that right?
No problem, but nothing more is going to be said about it. As far as I'm concerned, I'm chairman of the parish council, and there is no way that I can get involved on this sort of thing. No way.
Have you fallen out, you and John Bear?
Fell in again. No. No more. Finished. Nothing's to be said.
But can't you give us an idea of your thoughts on this?
No. No. Because I should tell a few others then, wouldn't I? No. Water under the bridge. Forget all about it. That's my opinion. Well, that's what I want to do now. So then get on. Sorry.
The feud centres around, of all things, gravel that's urgently required for the bypass.
No gravel left in the field at all, so they're bound to come this way. There's absolutely no chance of them going any further away. Sure of that.
Well, the dirt in the summer will be unbelievable.
Quite intolerable. That's right. I mean, the swimming pool would just be a mud bath, wouldn't it? I mean, ghastly. Can you imagine going down there on a Sunday morning, wind as high, you know, as it does when it comes across?
Tony's brother-in-law, Jumbo, is spitting blood over plans to extract the gravel from a field right beside his beloved 18th century house.
The amount of gravel they want to put in the bottom of the bypass, and they want to get it out from a great big borrow pit, which is a big hole in the ground right next door to my house, which is going to be about 20 yards away, 20 acres it's going to be, and they're going to dig out 200,000 cubic metres of gravel, which they then screen in a plant, you know, not very far. I mean, the plant's only about 400 yards from us.
What are you worried about?
Well, worried about the noise, the dirt. It'll be the biggest man-made lake Bentley's ever seen. I mean, they'll dig it wet if they dig it now.
Right on your doorstep?
Absolutely. I mean, 20 yards away, cricket pitch away from the boundary. No, cricket pitch away from this room.
Who owns this land here?
Tony Holmes. Tony Holmes, my brother-in-law, owns the land. Yep.
Do you think Tony could have resisted pursuing this?
I've no idea. I think probably it was hugely tempting.
You get a little remuneration for it, you know.
Mm. He's not offered to give you a few quid.
Oh, that wouldn't be a fun. Holmeses give anybody give their money away. They're not a chance.
Lunch break on the bypass. And Alison's entire business future now rests in the hands of a few ravenous corned beef and pickle connoisseurs.
How much is that?
A pound.
Yeah. Deliver?
Mmm.
Not bad at all.
Mmm.
They're okay, aren't they?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What do you make of them?
They're very good, yeah. And it's handy that they're delivered. We don't have to worry about going to the shop. So, yeah, it's convenient, it's nice.
You got them from the shop before, did you?
Yeah, we used to go down to the shop, but it's a lot easier. We don't have to worry about getting out.
They're better?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Thicker and chunkier.
What are you eating there?
Corned beef and pickle.
Nice?
Yeah, very good, very good.
That sentimental sandwich that was yours and
oh, dear. Down at the stores, there's an awful lot of sandwiches left on the shelf. Still, at least there was no break-in last night. Did Pinky's vigil scare them off, or was it simply the wrong night? The sleep-loving village Bobby is shortly to find out. A few days later, and to everybody's frustration, the attempted break-in at the village stores has taken place.
Yeah. Made a mess of that other big window, I see, isn't it?
That's right.
Yeah.
Not very good, is it?
Sure. Them and terrible.
Next time round, Pinky will have to rethink his strategy. It's a busy morning at the village hall. Little do the innocent toddlers in the playgroup realise that above them, the big guns from the county council are about to do battle.
When the lance of the village gets cracking and the whole platoon turns out.
It's D-Day in the war over the bypass gravel. And word is that to a man, they've already decided in favour of Tony.
Minerals policy panel.
Oh, yes, Charlie Graham.
Against them, one man now stands alone, Jumbo.
So this morning's meeting, is this really your last chance?
Well, I mean, I don't think I can quite hit the chairman of the committee, but I mean...
Would you like to?
Well, I think, yes, you know, you do get very heated about these things, don't you?
You going to win?
50-50, I should think. But I suspect, I think we've, you know, backs to the wall is the answer.
Thank you all very much for coming along this morning to...
If the councillors thought they were in for an easy ride, they'd reckoned without the legendary tenaciousness of Jumbo and his wife. Meanwhile, a quiet lane just outside the village.
OK, look, I'm going to have to put your blindfold on there. Sorry if I miss your ear, right? You'll have to move your head round a bit. My arms ain't got the arms like a monkey.
Brian's planning a pleasurable afternoon with his new girlfriend, Jackie.
I'm about to make a mess of it. After all that trouble you gave me, you're here.
He's spent weeks organising this, right down to the finest detail.
Do mine.
Yeah, 2 seconds. What you do, have you?
That's the benefit of having being follically challenged, I think is the word they use.
Is that what you call it?
Yeah, it is clean, I assure you. All right. Can you hear me?
That's better.
Can you hear now?
Yeah, I can now.
Can you hear now? All right, then. Say what I like now, then, come on.
In years to come, they'll still be talking of the day Jumbo took on the combined might of the county council.
The volume of granular substance will be greater than originally anticipated. A 3-metre bund is proposed quite close to the boundary of my property, Preston's, 15 metres, which is actually below my first floor bedroom window, and I can lie in bed and actually see everything going on. And it's only 1 3/4 times my height. That's me plus a bit. The smell of the subsoil is offensive. I also believe, as it will be dug wet in the winters, which you can easily see from the height of my pond and also a well in my garden, it'll be the biggest temporary man-made lake in Bentley since Victorian times.
What is it? I'm dying to know.
In a small field just to the west, strangers arrive.
What is it? What is it?
The eagle-eyed sisters, Hilda and Margaret, are first on the scene to investigate.
The way that I do, what is it? Please tell me, what is it?
Not nervous, are you?
Yes.
No need to be. Would I do anything silly?
No, not really,
no. That's a daft question, isn't it? Did you bring your swimming costume?
No, what for?
Well, you might need it. I'm glad you can swim, you can rescue me.
A bit cold for that, isn't it?
Oh, I don't know.
Round one to Jumbo. At least he's persuaded the enemy battalions to come and recce the battleground for themselves.
The dust coming off the top of the bund and into our swimming pool over here.
With only a hedge between Jumbo's house and the field, some of the councillors seem concerned. Questions are being asked.
Exactly how much you'll need. Perhaps if my colleague Anna Farmer could make a few comments, who's a resident engineer.
The problem is with putting the bund up, if we have to put the bund up round the site initially, we would have to work a certain area to install the bunds.
Not for a moment do Hilda and Margaret hesitate in approaching the strangers in the field.
I wouldn't mind.
Good evening, ladies.
Good evening.
Good evening.
My God, it looks enormous when it's laid out, doesn't it?
No, it's only a baby, this one.
It's only a baby,
this one's only a baby.
It looks very big.
Sharon's going to sort out the hall. Pinky's going to do the disco. He said if he can't do it, he'll try and get his dad to do it.
Having named the day, Alison's as keen as mustard to get things organised.
What else is there to sort out? Dee's making the dresses. Mm-hmm. What else is there then?
Have you decided where you're going to get married yet?
Hopefully. I mean, I would like to get married in Bentley Church, but no. Being as I've been divorced, they won't.
Why do you want to get married in a church?
because I've been married and divorced twice, and I haven't been married in church, and I think it's just right. I can't see why they shouldn't marry you in church. If you want to get married in church, you've been married before or not. Everybody makes mistakes, just that I've made two. This time's third time lucky, I hope.
We ain't got far to go anyway. You'll be glad to hear.
So far, so good. Everything's going exactly as Brian had planned.
We ain't got further to go.
That's all right then. I don't like being blindfolded.
Well, you got one consolation, haven't you?
What's that?
You ain't got to look at me.
Jumbo's bulldog spirit seems to be winning through. It's been referred back to HQ.
Come along this morning and express views to us and so on. The decision will actually be made on Monday at the Roads and Development Subcommittee, and that will be, you know, a final decision one way or the other.
Off we go, rain or snow, just like proper soldiers all in a row.
How do you think this meeting went this morning?
I think what we have done is we've given our best fight, and keep my fingers crossed. I'm going to go to the meeting on Monday. In Winchester, and I shall have my say again.
That's when the decision will be made.
Yeah, in front of the whole committee, and I'm entitled to speak for up to 10 minutes, and I shall do that too. Go down fighting if that's the way.
Roger.
The news is very frustrating for Tony. As chairman of the village parish council, as well as the landowner, he's not allowed to influence the final outcome.
Well, I reckon Monday. Do that. Bye.
For Brian's girlfriend Jackie, the ordeal is nearly over.
Right. Sit still a minute, I'll open the door. We're going down a dip, right? Now stop there and then put your legs right out. All right. If I go over, this is good.
Trust you.
I knew I'd mess it up. Right, it's slippery. First of all, yeah, now if you turn that way, keep watching
what
that way.
Not
that. All right, there's one. Okay.
Oh, God.
Do you fancy going up in it?
Yeah, why not?
You gonna go up in it?
Yeah, I will. Yeah, you will as well.
Now, I'm very reluctant about this.
Brian warned the pilot the surprise birthday treat would backfire if Jackie refused to get into the balloon.
Come here. Ready? Throw your arms around my neck, my darling. Hey,
that's it. Welcome. In your pot. Great stuff.
All right.
What I need
I won't
to
do
is
that to you. That's
right. No, it's like this has been a surprise.
Yes, it was, yeah.
Yeah, sure. Right, what
in fact, it's not Jackie that's the problem.
Brian, you're not getting second thoughts, are you?
Yeah, I want to get out. I want to go home.
No, you don't.
I want to go and watch Silla Black.
Listen, this is your idea. You've got nobody to blame.
Oh, dear.
Do you really feel nervous?
Hey, me? Oh, yeah. I am deadly serious.
You're as cool as anything, Jackie.
Oh, yeah.
I am
you're
doing
the one that everybody was worried about.
My legs are like jelly now.
Oh, come on, you're a man. You're all right, Jackie. Okay, yeah. Good for you.
Right, it's working. Hold tight, mind yourself, guys, if you could. Just because at the moment we've got a few little gusts coming through. Nothing to worry about. It's all right, just hold tight.
They're away at last by the skin of their teeth. And as they begin to drift away gently towards Glade Farm, surely there's nothing that could now go wrong.